okay, the children's table and manners and etiquette classes, but there are some for grown-ups too, thankfully, and a refresher course is not always a bad thing, especially when it comes to business meals. So we're excited. Julie Francis, etiquette and coordinator at the St. Paul Hotel. Great to have you.
Thank you so much for having me. We really appreciate it. You know, at the St. Paul Hotel, we're trying to do our little piece in reviving civility in the community by not only having tea, come join us for tea,
Ooh, tea.
A very refined environment, but also the etiquette classes.
I like that.
Yeah.
So what are, you have a test for me today.
I do. I have kind of an etiquette aptitude test.
This is probably a no-no, an iPad on
the
table.
Yeah, I know you can't look up answers. You could quickly check in the book, although it won't
quick. I was going to say, I was pretty intimidated when I saw this giant book of etiquette that is this thick. All right.
So, as you can see, we'd have lots to talk about.
Yes.
Before we get to the formal place setting, this is a gift for you and your staff afterwards.
Oh, well, thank
you.
But
we have these food items that can sometimes cause a quandary in how to eat them.
Okay.
Now, for those of us that teach etiquette, we can usually watch people eat a roll or soup, and we know, have you had an etiquette class? So, let's start with the roll. I will help you out and say that there should be a butter spreader.
Okay.
And how do you think you should approach a roll and eat it?
I would probably approach it with a knife.
Okay.
And I would pick it up and cut it, maybe?
Probably not.
No.
Probably not.
Well, I failed question one. So I'm doing that wrong.
Okay, so basically, when you have a butter and roll, you will take whatever you touch, you take, you put it on your plate, and then you will put butter on the side, not on the roll. And the correct way is actually you pick it up, you break off a bite.
Really?
You butter a small bite, put the knife back, and eat a bite.
And then you take
Dave,
a bite.
Dave, don't lick the knife.
No?
And don't put it back on the table. Go
well, that
back
was my
there.
Next step, yes, so I'm glad you jumped ahead of me.
So next one that we can tell if you've had an etiquette is, how would you correctly eat soup, and what would you do with this cracker?
Okay. All right. I think I know this.
Okay. First,
I feel like I would break the cracker inside the package because that would be less messy, right? And then open it up, and I'm getting a disapproving look as I dump this in. So I'm also guessing that I'm wrong.
Not the correct way
Not
to
the
eat
right.
it. Not the correct way to do that. Actually, if there are crackers with that, you will only break off a piece, but then you will retrieve it with your spoon. And the correct way to eat soup is that you hold it like a pencil, you dip to the back, bring it up, sip from the side, don't slurp
No
your
slurping.
Soup.
No that
slurping.
One I knew.
Yep. And then when you are done, put it on the plate that's underneath.
Okay.
So, correct way to eat soup. There's a little saying, as the ship goes out to sea, I dip the spoon away from me.
Well,
all right,
like
how
that.
About spaghetti?
It's a little saying that I'm 0 for 2. So, 0 for 3.
Said it correctly.
Okay. What I know what I do is,
okay.
So let's see. Do I guess I'm going to cut it into smaller pieces, right? And then I'm going to do just one little piece at a time.
Actually, you're close. You're getting better. We're getting better.
We're learning.
As we go along.
You can teach an old dog new tricks.
There's three ways to eat spaghetti. And one of them is that, of course, if you're not real accustomed to whirling and twirling, that you can just cut a section and lift it to your mouth.
I'm afraid if I whirl and twirl that it'll get on me.
And that can happen.
Yes.
But you can also use a
spoon
and twirl there. Or if you don't have a spoon, you can just twirl a few strands to make a nest. Lean
and
forward slightly, and there you go.
Okay, we have less than a minute.
Okay, let's
do you want to go to this one?
Let's do
asparagus.
Asparagus.
Okay, I know how I eat it. I pick it up and I eat it, and I guarantee that's wrong.
Actually, if that does not have sauce on it and it's
you're
for an appetizer, you're okay.
Hey, I got one exactly right. All right, bacon.
Bacon. If it is very crisp, impossible to cut, you can pick it up and eat it.
Whoops.
And if it's limp, you will use a knife and fork.
You have to use a knife and fork for bacon?
Well, here's the overall rule. Look at the environment in which the food is being presented and the property of the food, and that should kind of guide you as far as how you will eat it. And we can talk more about that another time.
I would just literally eat them all. Okay, so I was okay.
Yeah.
I'm not a completely lost
cause.
Yeah,
that's right.
Thank you so
much. Thank you so much for having us.
Adult etiquette class is next Saturday, April 13th. Do you have any spots left? Because I might need to come.
We would love to have you come.
Oh, good. 1:15, and we have a link to learn more and reserve your spot on KARE11.com.